Hello, good morning students. Now I am standing before you to teach physics of class 8 in the fourth session. In the first sessions we have completed the first periodic. In the second sessions we have completed up to the half yearly examination, and in the third sessions we have finished up to the second periodic. And in the last session, means fourth sessions, just I am going to finish for the final examination. In these sessions I will have to teach two chapter, chapter number 15, and next there will be the light. Name of this chapter is some natural phenomenon. In the natural phenomenon we will learn about the mainly charge, lightning, and syllabus for this is a natural nature of the charge, positive and negative charge, lightning conductor, conservation of the charge, and lightning and thundering, and the useful effect of the thunder. Now we have to know the charge. Charges are of two types. Number one, positive. Second, negative charge is a form. Charge is formed by losing of outermost electron, electrons or losing and gaining losing or gaining of electrons in the outermost cell. For example, any atom. Suppose that we have taken example sodium. Its atomic number is 11. Therefore, atomic number equal to number of protons equal to number of electrons. Therefore, number of protons equal to 11, because proton carry positive charge, and number of electrons equal to minus 11. And we know that protons are residing in the nucleus, whereas electrons are revolving around the nucleus. So we have to arrange the electron. Electrons participate in the chemical reaction. Outermost electron lose and gain. This is a cause of the formation of the charge. Electronic configuration of sodium. सिंस देर इज ए 11 इलेक्ट्रॉन देयर फोर वी कैन अरेंज इन द फर्स्ट सेल के सेल 2 के एल 8 एंड 1 इन द आउटर मोस्ट सेल के एल एंड एम. दिस इज कॉल्ड द वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन. दिस इज ए वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन द केस ऑफ मेटल. इन द चैप्टर ऑफ द मेटल नॉन मेटल केमिस्ट्री टीचर्स ऑल्सो यू हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड हाउ द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स लूज एंड गेन. इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ द केमिस्ट्री. सो बट हियर वी हैव टू एक्सप्लेन टू अंडरस्टैंड द चार्ज बेटर वे. दिस सोडियम विल लूज वन इलेक्ट्रॉन. तो सोडियम विल लूज वन इलेक्ट्रॉन देन द इलेक्ट्रॉन नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ऑन लूजिंग. Now there will be the 10, minus 10, and the protons will remain same, equal to plus 11. Therefore, plus 11 minus 10 equal to plus 1. Therefore, sodium is a forming positive charge. In this way, magnesium is also metal forming the plus 2 charge, and aluminium is also forming plus 3. Therefore, we can explain that when any atom lose its outermost electron, then it is forming the positive charge, and when any atom gain the electrons in its outermost shell to complete its octet. Losing and gaining is a taken place in the atom due to the completing its octet. Sodium here have lose one electrons to complete its nearest inert gas structure, that is neon 2-8. Octet is completed by losing one electron, then octet is in the outermost shell, there is 8 electrons, that's why it have lose. In this non-metal, the electron is again to complete its octet. We know that in the outermost shell, if the number of electrons in the outermost shell is 1, 2, 3, then that will be the metal. And if the number of electrons in the outermost shell 4, 5, 6, and 7, that will be the non-metal. And if the number of electron in the outermost shell is 8, that is the inert gas. So inert gas do not participate in any chemical reaction. In this way, we have developed the concept of the charge. All the metals are forming the positive charge by losing outermost electrons to complete its octet, whereas non-metals are gaining the electrons. Now the explanation of the non-metal. How the non-metals form the negative charge. Oxygen, O, 8, the number of electrons and atomic number, oxygen is 8, proton plus 8, electron minus 8, electronic configuration of oxygen 2-6 means in the outermost shell. This is the outermost valence electrons 6. This is incomplete, not completed octet. Therefore, oxygen will gain the electrons. This gain electrons. Electrons gain. How much? 2 electrons. 2 electrons it will gain. Therefore, present after gaining the electrons, new configuration is 2 and 8. Therefore, completed the octet. completed the octet. Now electron is a 10 and the proton is a remain 8. Therefore net charge minus 10 plus 8. Therefore this will be the minus 2. So oxygen will form, oxygen minus 2, charge is formed. Hence we can say that metals are forming the positive charge and non-metals are forming the negative charge. In this way we have the concept of the charge. Charge are of the two types, positive and negative charge. Metals are always forming the positive charge and non-metals are always forming the negative charge. On the basis of losing and gaining, the charge is formed, because every atom is a neutral in nature, because the number of protons and the number of the electrons are equal and they have no any type of the charge they have. But when they lose or gain, then only it is possible to forming the charge. Otherwise they are said to be neutral, because the number of the protons and the number of the electrons are equal, and that's why they are said to be neutral and neutral state. After that, giving the concept of the charge by metal and the non-metal, metal always forming the positive and the non-metals are always forming the negative charge. We have two electric charge in the atoms. Now we can say that types of the charges is also completed. And next, equal and opposite charge. Properties of charge. Properties of charge. Number one, same charge repel each other, means positive and positive will repel, and negative it will also repel. One positive, opposite charges, same charge repel each other, and opposite charge attract each other. Opposite charge attract each other. One positive and other is a negative. Attract. Next, negative and positive. This will also attract. These are said to be the properties of the charges. Equal and opposite charges. In this way, we can say that there are properties of the charges. Same charge repel each other, means positive, repel, negative, repel, opposite charge attract each other. One is a positive, other is a negative, this will attract, and one is a positive and other is a negative and a positive, then it will also attract. In this way, we can explain the properties of the charge. These are called the same charge and the opposite charge. Now, why a charge a body? Way of charging of the body. Next topic, way. way of charging body. How you will charge? There are three ways we can charge the neutral body. A neutral body can be charged. A neutral body can be charged by following way. Number one, charging by rubbing or friction. Charging by rubbing or friction, that is also called the friction. When two bodies are rubbed each other, then there is a charge developed in the two bodies. One are gaining the negative charge and one is losing the negative charge. Then those who gain the negative charge are said to be the negatively charged, and those who are losing the electrons, they are said to be the positively charged. As I have explained in the case of the sodium, potassium, aluminium, so on. When you are rubbing the comb with your hair, then you are finding that comb is attracting the neutral substances like the papers, bits of paper and a stream of the water, that is caused by the charge produced in the comb. One is said to be the positive charge and one is said to be the negative charge. This is the way number one. Second number, charging by conduction. Charging by conduction. We can explain conduction. When a charged body brought near the uncharged body and touch them, then some charges move from the charged body to uncharged body, and when both the body becomes equal charge, then the flow of charge stop and both are said to be the equal charges. It means whenever you are asked to charge a neutral body by the method of the conduction, then you have to brought the charged body and touch the neutral body. The neutral body will gain the charge from the charged body till both acquired the equal number of the charges. When both the body becomes equal amount of the charge and equal charges, then the flow of charge will stop. Okay, this is known as a charging by conduction. Next, charging by induction. Induction means when a charged body is brought near the uncharged body, you have not to touch them. Now in the conduction you have touched the charged body. Suppose that this is the charged body and this is uncharged body. If you are touching them, then this will lose the charge and this is gaining the charge. When both the chalk will have the same amount of the charge, then the flow of the charge from this to this will stop. This is known as the method of the charging by conduction. But in the case of the charging by induction, then it means ए चार्ज बॉडी इज ब्राउट नियर द अनचार्ज बॉडी देन by the influence of the charge some charge removed from this and this becomes also charge then this is known as the charging by induction in this way influence of the charge one body is charged also for the time being that is called the charging by induction in this way we can charge the neutral body in three ways by induction. Next, already I have explained the charging by friction means rubbing. When you are rub the two bodies, then that will gain the electrons and one body lose and one body gain the electrons and in this way the charge is formed in two bodies. One is a loser and one is a gainer and those who have lose the electrons are said to be the positively charged and those who have gained the electrons are said to be the negative charge. So one will be the positive and the other will be the negative. In this way we can. Now the topic is how to detecting and measuring the charge. How you will detect the charge and measure the charge. Charge also can be measured with the help of certain device that is called the electroscope. Detecting, next topic, detecting and measuring the charge, detecting and measuring the charge. This can be done with the help of electroscope. Electroscope is a device. It is a device in this way. A container glass jar is taken. This is the cork. Gold leaf. Metallic rod. Rubber. Stopper. Metallic disc. Disc, metallic disc, wooden base. Next, this is a glass jar.
glass jar.
Now, this is the electroscope. We have charged, positively charged. At first, we have to prepare the gold leaf electroscope. For preparing the gold leaf electroscope, a necked bottle is required, and a rubber stopper, a metallic rod made of the silver or gold. This is the gold leaf, very thin leaf of the gold, and a wooden base on which we can put this system, and this is the metallic disc made of the silver or gold. All are fitted inside the glass jar, and it is charged. This gold leaf is charged with positive charge. At first, it is charged. Gold leaf electroscope is taken. Now, if you are asked to test a body to whether that is a charged body or uncharged body, then we have to brought the rod or any substances, and we have to touch the metallic disc. The amount of the divergence and convergence, if positive charge is taken to test, since it is the positive charge, you are knowing the gold leaf electroscope, it is a positively charge. If you are brought near the positively charge, then there will be the divergence. If there is a divergence in the gold leaf electroscope, then you can say that this is the positively charge. Okay, and if there is a convergence, means both the leaves will come close together, then you can say that you have brought the negatively charge. In this way, you can deduct the positive charge and the negative charge using the gold leaf electroscope. The amount of the divergence and the amount of the convergence take place in the gold leaf of the gold leaf electroscope, that tell us that whether you are testing the positive charge or negative charge. In this way, our topic, detecting and measuring the charge, has been completed. Next, I am going to explain the next topic, is that charge in the atmosphere or atmospheric electricity. In the atmosphere, there is also charge form. That you see or know during the thunderstorm, during the rainy season, shown. Next topic is the charge in atmosphere. Charge in atmosphere or atmospheric electricity. Atmospheric electricity. Atmospheric electricity. Charge in the atmosphere. We know that atmosphere containing the small droplets, particles, and a small ice slip. Due to the wind movement, all the droplets, water droplets, and ice particles are move each other, and there is a tremendous friction between them, and there is accumulation of the charge created due to the friction, due to the movement. And whenever there is a excess charge accumulated in the cloud and then jumped towards the earth because earth have the zero potential. Earth having zero potential. Then due to having the zero potential, always charge have tendency to move from the higher potential to the lower potential. So the charge jumped through the air to the earth. That is called the discharging. Discharging of the charge is known cause the sparking as well as a cracking, and due to the electricity generate air expanded, and it also produce the sound. This is the called the atmospheric electricity as well as the charge in the atmosphere. After that, this is also the static electricity. For the time being, it is developed, and after sometimes it has been automatically becomes neutral. So this is called the statics and not move. Thank you. Have a nice day. In the next class, remaining part of this chapter, I will do. Thank you.